We are getting a new Sims expansion pack. Hi guys, it's Eve. Welcome back to my channel. So, we have some exciting Sims news, some very exciting news. So every quarter, EA bring out a Sims 4 roadmap, basically, sort of giving a little bit of a hint as to what we can expect, what new releases they will be. They usually just announce like what sort of pack it'll be. So it'll be a stuff pack, kit pack, game pack, expansion. And then they give us like little hints as to what the theme's gonna be and to what might be included. Now, the last one was the sort of Season of Love pack, where we got the new expansion pack, Lovestruck, which I love, excuse the pun. And that roadmap went up to the end of August. So we've been expecting a new roadmap and they have delivered. They've brought out a new one for the next quarter, but they've actually given us so much information. They've told us outright what the new additions are going to be and even when they're going to be released. We're going to dive into it and I'm going to tell you everything that we know about it. This season of To Be Continued. And this is really interesting, like all the moons and everything. I get very much like astronomy, tarot card vibes. And actually the video that's in a minute is literally has tarot cards in it. That was just like the first impression I got from it. But from September through to December, it will basically, this is going to be the season and there's going to be content that adds new chapters to your Sims stories. So there's even a mention of like warm cup of cocoa, tarot cards. So interesting to see how that's gonna tie in. Is there gonna be like an astronomy hobby or career added somewhere? A new chapter suggests it's gonna be adding very much to gameplay and life stages, which sort of gets confirmed a bit later on. So this is the video that we're going to watch. A reading for the season, very much tarot cards. There's literally tarot cards here, which immediately makes me think that we are going to get something about astronomy, tarot card reader, psychic, that potentially might be a hobby or like an additional career of some sort. So the first one says, one, like straight out, it says, we're getting an artist studio kit and a storybook nursery kit. It literally just comes out and tells us that immediately. I really like the sound of this. So this sounds like it's going to be adding to sort of the like painting hobby and sort of career. So potentially it's going to give us items that we can make a really nice artist studio. I really like this because I think adding more to hobbies is going to give more incentive to do those hobbies. And I think like painting is something I do sometimes on Sims, but not loads. So I'm like, well, I just leave them to it and then potentially sell it or hang it up and that's about it. I don't have much of an incentive to make them paint. But if there was something fun like an artist studio kit and enough to build them like a proper studio, that would be really cool. And if it would like enhance that, I love the idea of that because I think hobbies are such a great way to add to the gameplay. Like if you are getting a bit bored of your usual sort of family gameplay or have done loads of careers and you want to try something new, that could be quite nice. I can imagine being in any of the really nice like Henford and Bagley or one of the rest like cozy worlds, having your like house and then in the garden you have like a studio, your artist studio where you go and paint. Like that sounds so good. And then we're also getting a storybook nursery kit. So this now sounds like it's gonna be very much focused on the younger Sims. Unsure if this will be like baby focused, infant focused, maybe it'll be a bit of both. It'd be nice if we did get some more items that were baby focused, because like all we have for babies are cots. And I understand that's because they can't do anything really. But potentially it'll be that it's more that the parents can do. Like maybe they can now read to babies. Maybe they can like pick them up and sit in a little reading area or something with them. It'll probably be things that overlap, things that can be done with babies, but also infants. I think infants will probably be the main bit. And as it's a kit, it's not really going to add much gameplay, but maybe it'll just be that you can now make a really lovely nursery for your babies and infants and toddlers. I can imagine it being quite like whimsical theme because that storybook, it may be like, I can imagine there being like fun little like stickers for the wall. You can basically make the nursery seem like they're in a storybook, which would be really nice. I'm really intrigued by this. And because I do really enjoy the family gameplay aspect, this could help maybe make that, just enhance it and make it even more like real. And they've said when it's gonna be released. Those two kits are gonna be released same date, September 19th. So we don't have long to wait at all, literally like less than 2 weeks. So that is super exciting. Now that with it saying to be continued, trying to figure out how that ties in. So I guess storybook makes sense because it's like adding to the younger Sims of life. So it's showing how like that's new life. That's a chapter of their life and you're enhancing it. But maybe they're looking at just making that baby infant stage even better because there's only so much that they can do at the minute. And then artist studio, I don't fully get that. Maybe it's like you're like finding yourself again or something. Trying to give you hobbies so that you can like breathe new life into your Sims' life by making them find a new hobby, do new things. And one of those things is painting more maybe. On the left here, the picture is like a woman dipping her foot into a pool. This, like, because this to me is nothing like artistry or story, but I saw a rumor actually about this, that could this be a sign that in the expansion pack that we'll go into a minute, could that be a Fountain of Youth? It's just quite like intriguing. Like, I don't fully understand. It almost made me think like Garden of Eden, which would make sense, that new chapters, new life, but it doesn't shout art, studio or storybook, so I'm not entirely sure. Maybe we will get like an outfit like this, almost like a togo sort of thing. Now for the second tarot card. Reaper's Rewards event. So, new chapter, Reapers. So this is now very much like end of life sort of idea. This is, so where there's been login events, daily login events, where you can unlock things and win things if you log into the game every single day. There was an event on this before, which I was really bad at keeping up with, and they're doing a new one that's going to be Reaper's Rewards related. So this makes me think it's going to basically probably like lead up to Halloween and be very like spooky, dark sort of theme. Maybe it's going to give you things that you can then use for Halloween. I could very much imagine that. Interesting here, so that's like some sort of mask or something. Like, will that be one? Like a costume or something like that. Yeah, maybe they'll add some Halloween-y thing. You know, maybe there'll be certain gravestones you can get if you log in. Unsure. This doesn't hugely excite me because I find like the login rewards, sort of these rewards events, quite stressful, because then if I miss out because I can't log on a day, I feel really bad. I'm like, oh, whatever, I can't. I'll never be able to access that item again, and that would have actually been really nice. It's annoying when you do put so much time into the game, and it's just that because you can't log in on one day, I don't know, it doesn't quite sit right with me, and it actually just makes me quite like frustrated and like sad, and makes me, just gives me so much stress. I'm like, oh damn it, I've missed out on that. And as much as the rewards are cool, it gives me more excuse the pun grief than anything. This doesn't hugely excite me because I'm like, well, I'm probably gonna end up missing out on some of these, so I don't really want to get too excited, you know. So that is going to start from September the 24th. Now the reward seasons usually are a bit longer, so it might not be that it just stops at Halloween. It might keep going and be like sort of throughout November. Maybe they'll then do like bonfire night stuff, who knows, but it very much seems like they're going to follow the sort of theme of like the season, the part of the year, with it being now getting like into the darker months. There's events like Halloween, bonfire night, that sort of thing. Now for the next and super exciting one, we are getting a new expansion pack. This is going to be called the Life and Death expansion pack, which is, I already knew about this, I've been trying to not accidentally spoil it too much, where I've been alluding to life, new life, end of life, but this is very much what seems to be, even though it's saying the theme is to be continued, this life and death seems to be sort of the crux of what they're going off. And this picture here, we've got the grim but holding flowers, that's like life, which makes me think this expansion pack is going to be focusing on adding things, with the Grim Reaper being such a prominent thing in that picture, probably mainly adding things around death and the end of Sims life, but also adding some things on like living life, maybe new life. So that sense of why storybook nursery element adds in, because it's like, well, they're adding stuff to the new life Sims, the younger Sims that are just starting life. It's adding to that, and then also adding things and gameplay to end of life, like elders or whatever after they die. So this is really interesting. Well, in terms of what this might look like, so one thought I had is that potentially, so expansion packs always come with a new world. And I was wondering if, what if this is adding, this expansion pack is basically adding that when a Sim dies, there's, you can still play with them, or there's still more that can be done. There's like another element, like an afterlife, which actually link into the life section as well. And that maybe the world that's added, I saw someone say, could it be like an underworld? And then I thought, well, what if it's like a world where the Sims that have died go, and then you can go to that world and play as them, and maybe those Sims can't go back, or if they leave that world, they're then either they're ghosts all the time, or if they leave that world, when they're in any other worlds, they are ghosts, but when they're in this life and death world, they are like normal Sims, but they're just, they can't age, maybe they're like limited in what they can do, or obviously different interactions, stuff like that. And that, yeah, if they leave, you can then as a Sim maybe like haunt or be a guardian angel or something like that. And then maybe other Sims that are alive can visit, but maybe in a similar way with like Glimmerbrook, you have to like go through a portal and visit or something like that. And like this world is very much where like the Grim sort of lives. I just could really imagine this like an afterlife world. And then it means you can continue playing with your Sims even after they're dead, but keeping the immersion, because you wouldn't want the stakes to then be lowered of, well, oh wow, well, my Sim's dead, but doesn't matter because I can still play as them. Like having that thing of either they can't come back, or it's hard to go back to the other world, or yeah, if they do, they're a ghost. So it's not like you can just continue playing with them as normal. I could so imagine something like that happening. The other thing that's been sort of rumored is if one of the things they might add, because there's always usually a new career with an expansion pack, and if the career might be Freelancer Grim Reaper. So you can basically be the Grim Reaper. Maybe like the first level is like the Grim Reaper's apprentice or something like that. Soul sorter, where you like sort through the souls, or underworld manager, and then you become the Grim Reaper. Or just the freelancers, you're just the Grim Reaper. I'm trying to wrap my brain about how that would work, because you'd want it to be like a live career and something you can actively do things in, because otherwise it would sort of be a bit underwhelming. Okay, you change into the Grim's clothes and leave and that's it. Obviously, it's a little bit morbid, like playing as a Grim Reaper and people are dying, but like you would hope that if they're doing that, that they do it properly and then you can play as them. Otherwise, it's a little bit like, what's the point if it's not a live career? But yeah, so I'm intrigued by that theory. Then linking with the life thing, I could imagine like the psychic career or something with the tarot reading, astronomy, because there's a lot of that with the tarot cards, everything. I feel like there must be an aspect of that tied in somewhere here. And maybe it's like you can predetermine how someone dies. Like if you get a tarot card that says you're going to die like this, and then that happens to your sim or something like that. I'm not sure. I think I'm getting so focused on the death element of this pack. Like I'm guessing there must be like quite a few new deaths they're going to add, but I'm intrigued about then what this life aspect is going to be, and is it that they're going to be adding more milestones, more stages, more things to like when you have a new baby or when you age up, that you get there, something new happens. I'm not too sure, and at the minute it is all just speculation, but we are going to get a first look of this on October 3rd, so we don't have too long to wait, and we can get a little bit more insight into this, and we can maybe decipher from that first look if we can see what else we might be able to gather that's going to be included. It does seem like it's going to be Grim Reaper focused and really focused on that death element, because some things that were leaked showed that as being like the main thing, and also the fact the Grim Reaper literally takes up like majority of that photo, I think means that's going to be the focus. So unfortunately, with like a lot of the expansion packs, they don't always have loads and loads to them, so I can't imagine both the life and death aspect being both hugely in detail. I think they'll probably focus on one, which will be that death aspect, and there'll be a few new aspects that will like link to that life element. I don't think they'll bulk out both loads, because that feels like it's just a bit, for what we know to expect from an expansion pack, I think they'll just basically focus on one of those. Launch is going to be October 31st. So we know already when we're going to get the expansion pack, and it is on Halloween, which I love. And that really makes sense. Like this is obviously very seasonal, very relevant for the time, and life and death, it makes sense for it to be Halloween. And I'm excited about this because I never do anything on Halloween. So I now have plans. I will be playing Life and Death and streaming it. So make sure you follow me on Twitch so you don't miss that. This is just so broad though. It's like there's so much that could be, but just trying to focus on that Grim Reaper element. And I think definitely Grim Reaper cloak will now be able to change into. Oh, and then it says, and free updates. Who knows what that is? Could be anything, but wait and see. Ooh, but interesting actually on this one, like what's around it? These sort of, is that going to be a link to the new world? Maybe this looks like a church. Maybe there will be something with like a graveyard or something to add to that. Like once people die, there's like an actual graveyard you can go to. And maybe through the graveyard, maybe you go to the graveyard and through there is like the portal or a secret place you can go through to find the like the underworld or the afterlife. That's a theory. And then at the end, it just says to be continued. I think everyone's thought, what's more to come then? I think they're trying to keep the suspense, and because it's the anniversary, maybe they have got some things sort of up their sleeves, some surprises, which would be amazing. But that is the sort of whole theme of the roadmap. And that's what I think it's saying, is just to be continued, September to December. That's the theme of the roadmap. I personally don't see fully how the to be continued ties in with all of these. That's why I really think the like afterlife thing could be a part of this, because it's saying to be continued, like, your Sims die, but there's more to come. That's not the end anymore. There's going to be something else. Do you know what I mean? Like, that's what I think. Or even with the, like, tarot cards reading, if maybe you can, like, have tarot cards and it determines your path of life and you can change things, saying like there's more that's going to happen to your Sims, their life's to be continued, there's all these different paths you can go down and like your decisions are going to impact it, something like that. Like, that shouts to me the afterlife thing, to be continued, that even after your Sims die there's something else now that's going to be added. That's what I'm getting from that, but we'll wait and see. We don't have that long not to wait at all. We've got the kits coming out very soon that I'm really excited to try. They seem very much up my street. Some of the ones that came out in the Season of Love I didn't actually get, and I don't know if I will get, because they were very build mode focused, outdoorsy, that sort of thing. And that's not my sort of style. I like family gameplay and just general gameplay rather than building. But the artist studio and the storybook nursery, even though they're obviously going to be build items, potentially there might be some cast stuff as well, which I'd be really excited about. Like maybe like a painted apron, like a messy apron, maybe some more like clothes for babies and toddlers and infants. And because that links into the gameplay, the life play, the family play, I think I'm going to like those kits more. I think they will actually probably be something I use quite, I mean, I don't know yet, I haven't seen what they look like, but I feel like if any kits were to be up my street and something I'd like, I think it would be them. They seem like they're going to integrate into the way that I play the game. Yes, so intrigued about the Life and Death one, which, yeah, again, don't have long to wait. First look in less than a month, 3rd of October, and the game going to be released on Halloween. This seems like a really sort of different one. You know, I've never been so like, oh my God, I don't know where this is going. Usually you can sort of guess, but this one, like, I feel like there's so much that it could be. And I'm like, how far are they going with this? How ambitious? How much they're gonna give us? This could be wild and like add so much to it, but I just don't know how much they're gonna give us. Let me know what you think about this in the comments. Let me know if you have any theories about what this expansion pack or the kits may involve. And yeah, make sure you stay tuned as well, because whenever we hear any updates, I'll be letting you know on here. The first look comes out, I'll be doing a full in-depth like review of it, so make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss that and have notifications on. But yeah, thank you so much for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a huge thumbs up. I'd be so grateful, and I'll see you in the next one.